हेलो फ्रेंड्स, नमस्कार, सत श्री अकाल, सलाम, दिस इज़ अमित कपूर। सो आज टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग सब्जेक्ट्स सब्जेक्ट फॉर यंगस्टर्स स्पेशली बिकॉज एवरीवन वांट्स लाइफ पार्टनर, एवरीवन वांट्स लव लाइफ, एवरीवन वांट्स अ नाइस लाइफ पार्टनर हु केयर हिम और हर, हु टेक केयर हिम और हर, और यू नो ऑलवेज गिव लॉट ऑफ strength in hard time. This is the meaning of life partner. Life partner is not a meaning of only we are spending some good time with each other, and when if anyone is in crisis from couple and they leave each other. So I hear lot of cases they spend some quality time with each other, and when boy is suffering due to some problem, some family issues, and then the wife leave the husband. So today my topic is linked with your love affair, love life, your marriage life, and your relationship with your spouse, which is very, very, very precious relationship on this earth. So if we calculate in astrology, especially in birth chart, then we need to calculate first 5th house and 7th house. 5th house is your love life, 5th house is your emotions, 5th house is a house of your internal relationship with your spouse or your loved one. 7th house is a house of your, you can say, life partner, relationship with your wife, understanding with your wife. And if you are in love affair, then we need to check your 5th house. If you are married person or if you are married woman, then we need to check your 7th house. So if any benefic planet like Venus, Jupiter, Moon, placed in your 5th house, or the aspecting is on your 5th house, you are very lucky in the terms of love affair. If any malefic planet placed in 5th house or aspecting on 5th house, like Rahu, Saturn, or Ketu, these are natural malefic planets. If they are aspecting is on your 5th house, you are very unlucky in the terms of love affair. You may get in touch with 2-3 girls before your marriage in the terms of affair, but you are not getting success in the love affair because 5th house is damaged due to the malefic planet placed in your 5th house or aspecting malefic planet is on your 5th house. And the same condition apply on your 7th house. If Venus, Moon, Jupiter, Mercury placed in your 7th house, you are very fortunate in the terms of wife. Your wife is very caring, very lovable to you, and she will always ready to support you. She give lot of attention and lot of love to you. But if Rahu plays in 7th house, for example, if Rahu is in conjunction with any benefic planet, natural benefic planet like Jupiter, Sun, Mars, Moon, Venus, Mercury, natural benefic planet Rahu conjunction or Ketu conjunction in 7th house, like with Mars, Sun, Moon, Jupiter, you will definitely get disturb in your marriage life. You may interested in second marriage and divorce. I seen if Rahu plays in 7th house, and if Saturn or Rahu plays in 7th house, there is a strong chances for two marriages. There is a strong chances for delay in marriage. And especially if Venus is in your 5 number in birth chart, like Leo sign, and if Venus is in your Cancer sign, Venus is in your Virgo sign, you will definitely disheartened whole life from your love life. You are never satisfied from your love life. You are never satisfied from your husband's side. You are never satisfied from your affair side if Venus is in 4 number Cancer, 5 number Leo, and 6 number Virgo. So guys, we need to check which type of 5th house and 7th house placement planet in our natal chart, and which type of same houses condition in Navash D9 birth chart. If Venus is in damage in D9 birth chart, Navash birth chart, it means you will never satisfy in your relationship. That may be personal life, that may be love life, that may be your marriage life, that may be your affair. You always get confused and disturbed, and your life partner will never give you the support because your 5th house damage, your 7th house damage. So guys, we need to know which type of position of our planets in our birth chart. I saw a lot of birth chart, and I sitting with lot of peoples, they are married from last 5-7 years, but they're still not happy because something is missing in them life, like no kids after marriage, or no gains, materialistic gains. They're suffering no business, no job. There's a lot of problem. They may live together, but they are not living a happy life because her birth chart is not matching with each other. And Rahu, Ketu or Saturn aspecting is on 7th house or 5th house, or Venus is damaged in birth chart. So if Venus is in 5 number, Leo sign, if Venus is in 4 number, Cancer sign, if Venus is in 6 number, Virgo sign, a native will never satisfy from your spouse. A native will always disheartened. He's always feeling alone. His emotions, his or her emotions are always affected. He's feeling like this, oh, I am alone in this earth. No one can understand me. No one can understand my feelings, because this is due to the your damage of your fifth house. Fifth house is a dharma trikon sthan, which play a biggest role in our birth chart. Seventh house is a house of Kendra Sthan, which is directly linked with your life partner and your business partner, your sexual player. And 12th house also play your sexual player, but that is with other women, not with wife. If you want to see your sexual life, then we consider your 7th house or your 5th house. Which type of affection you have with your life partner, which type of understanding you have with your life partner, which type of foundations you have, emotionally touch you have. That is all your 7th house, and especially Venus placement. So I have some experience about astrology. I'm doing astrology. I'm a student of astrology. I'm doing practice from so many years. So I saw if Mars is also placed in your 7th house, if Mars is also placed in your 1st house, 4th house, 7th house, a native will definitely get disturbed in marriage life. And he will be in, you can say, always planning to separate from our life partner. So guys, I'm trying to deliver one message through astrological video. No doubt the relationship, marriage is a very small world, you know, but maintaining a marriage life is very difficult. To stay in marriage life is very difficult. I am married. The world is very simple. The make a balance between husband wife is very difficult. So I would suggest you to everyone, every of my viewers, please be positive if you are suffering from your marriage life, because like a lot of ascendants right now suffering from the personal relationship, like Capricorn especially, and second Taurus is little bit affected, and Rahu is entering in the first house in Taurus ascendants from 23rd of September, and you can say Scorpio ascendants also affected from this after 23rd of September. If you are already in any type of problem related to your marriage life, you must consult with any astrologer. You must analyze your birth chart, which type of planets you have, which type of Mahadasha you have right now. And if you are going to apply divorce, is this right decision for you? Or this relationship will work out after a few months, he will guide you thoroughly as per your birth chart. Don't take any big decision like a divorce or marriage in a very simple way. Okay, yes, I love you, you love me, let's go to marriage. This is not like that. Marriage is a big, very big, you can say, relationship, very strong, big relationship, which is very precious. So I would suggest you, everyone, don't lose your heart if you are facing tough phase relating to your personal life. Stay strong and stay happy. Try to be positive and polite in this relationship, and must consult with any astrologer and talk with them. Sit with the astrologer. He will guide you. He will consult you which type of planets you have, where is your malefic planet, where is your Venus. Venus is in your 5 number, or Venus is in your 4 number or 6 number. Do you have a successful marriage life or not? Is there two marriages in your birth chart, or you will happy in one marriage life? This is all in birth chart. Birth chart, root of our life. So you must consult with any astrologer. This is my advice for you. And thank you for watching my video. I really appreciate your efforts. I really appreciate your trust and love which you are showing on me. I'm trying to do my best to update astrological things. Namaskar, Sat Sri Akal, Salaam.